On 10 better than Wayne Gretzky, the Kings are home to Quebec tonight. Yzerman, Messier, Nichols, and Hall with 55 goals leads the NHL in that category. Incidentally, our update game tonight will be from the Forum in Montreal. The Canadiens reeling from a loss last night in Buffalo by host to Hartford. Now we're set for the action here. Let's go once again to Bob Cole and Harry Neal.
Thank you, Ron, and good evening, everybody. The referee is there at center ice. That's Kerry Fraser. Bob Hodges and Ray Scapinello are the two linesmen. And the goaltenders in this hockey game tonight. As we mentioned earlier, Sean Burke, the shining star with New Jersey, 10-5-3 in his last 18. There's no doubt they're counting heavily on Burke in their run for the playoffs. Alan Bester, in his last outing on Thursday, he stopped 38 shots in the Flyers' 3-0 shutout of the Maple Leafs. He's 15-11-0 this season. Bester and Burke, the goaltenders. Brooke, Brown, and Maley starting up front for New Jersey against McIntyre, Franceschetti, and Pearson for the Maple Leafs. Marsh and Iafredi are the Leaf defensemen. Danico and Driver are on the defense starting for New Jersey.
Well, the media has played this game up to be enormous from a physical viewpoint. Most of the time when they do that, it's a very placid game. But we know the Leafs play better when they play tougher. And Jersey has dressed their toughest lineup. Here are the players not playing tonight. You can see there are six not dressed for Jersey. Not all of them are hurt.
That's Danico, number three for the New Jersey Devils. Brown on the right side to center, and he flipped it into the Maple Leaf zone. Maley is coming in a hurry. Bester out of the net, can't clear it. A shot from the line is deflected. Wide of the net as Driver took a shot. Hoping to get it through the screen in front of Bester. Danico in his own zone. Brooke was with him for a moment. Now Maley to Brooke. Across center ice, winding up at the line, and he just missed with that wicked shot. Franceschetti coming down. That is Lou. As Franceschetti picks it up, you'll hear the crowd help him along. Get the puck out of the zone to center ice. Lehman to the line. Osborne catching up. Here is Olchek. Passes in front of the net. Lehman was there. Another chance. Weak shot by Osborne. Good line this one for the Maple Leafs. Curvers to Lehman. Can't get a shot. Osborne to Curran. Side of the net. It hits the side of the goal.
Lehman was one against four Devils. Lehman's four teammates changed. And so Gary was trying to get some time till some of his teammates got into the zone. And in the meantime, there was the delayed penalty called on number 15, John McClain. So the breakaway that you mentioned, Bob, would have been blown anyway.
1:58, the time of the penalty. First one of the game. And there he is. McClain. Of New Jersey. So the Leafs and their power play has been pretty good.
Oh, boy.
Started the season rather anything but great, but boy, it has caught fire.
Six now. It's terrific. John Cunniff, the 14th head coach in the franchise history, grading back to Kansas City in 1974. Team is 3-5-2 in their last 10. It must remind John of the Kansas City Scouts the way they're playing.
The Leafs will have to come back to get things going as the Devils shoot it down the ice. Curvers, Ramage, the defenseman. And Curvers has been a big help on this Leaf power play. Domfus, Pearson, and Marois. Domfus handling the puck well. Put a pass over in front of the net. The Devils are going to clear it out. That's Danico handing it off. Sundstrom took the pass from Muller, but it was called on the offside.
Well, Doug Carpenter's done a great job this year coaching the Leafs. He knows that his team needs a win tonight to stay alive in the hunt for first place in the Norris Division. As you mentioned, Bob, they go out west to play Calgary, Edmonton, and Vancouver after 4 days in a row off. What a great time of the year to have your team get 4 consecutive days off. You can have a couple of good practices and give his elder statesman a couple of days of good rest.
Domfus remains on. Brook is number 10 for New Jersey, winning the draw. Fedosov, number 2, is also on the ice. Kasatunov, the other defenseman. The Soviet blue liners. Here's Kermers, trying to do a job on him now, and he can't do it. Kasatunov got the puck out of his own zone, all the way down to Bester for Domfus. Brook in to watch him. Domfus takes a look at Kervers on the left side and then decides to skate himself. Now to Osborne. Osborne lost control at the blue line. And this will be offside as Lehman picks it up. They haven't had a shot on this power play yet. 57 seconds left in the McLean penalty.
Well, the Leafs have 59 power play goals this year, and they are 6th in the league at a healthy 23.2%. The penalty killing for the New Jersey Devils is 12th in the league. And they are doing all right in that department of the special teams. It's their penalty killing that isn't so good. The New Jersey Devils are against sub-500 teams this year, are a measly 11-13-3. And goals for have been tough lately, only 25 in their last 11 games, as they're in the hunt for a playoff spot in the tough Patrick Division.
Kasatunov had to go back quickly. Chopping at it was Lehman. But the Devils are doing a pretty good job killing off this first penalty of the hockey game. John McClain is in the penalty box. Osborne is on the move with Olchek. Olchek made a pretty good move at the blue line. Kasatunov and then lost it. Bester got his arm up to stop that hot shot from Sundstrom. And it goes over the glass.
Alan Bester's 1-1-1 against the Jersey Devils in his career as a Toronto Maple Leaf. And Doug Carpenter seems to be in the spot now with their goaltending, Bob, that he can play either one and feel pretty good about his choice. And he hasn't had that luxury the whole time he's been a coach for the Toronto Maple Leafs.
Young Jeff Reese, the backup again tonight, and he is coming on every game he plays. Olchek getting the faceoff back to Ramage. Burke still waiting for his first shot of the game. Ramage gives it to him. And then Burke lost it. Here's Lehman. Oh, Lehman, a high shot. And it's his second shot of the game. This one is in.
Gary Lehman with an absolute bullet wrist shot scores his 40th goal of the season. You've seen lots of hard shots in your days broadcasting games, Bob, but I don't know whether you've seen any wrist shot any harder than this. A terrible play by Burke, who tried to be a little too creative, but watch this shot by Lehman. Burke had no chance, right upstairs. Not many players can get it up that quickly with that velocity.
3:46, the time of the goal. Lehman unassisted. 1-0 Toronto. Ramage the shot. It's another power play goal for the Maple Leafs.
How, when you're hot, you get him any old way, even when the other goalie sets you up.
They had just 2 shots, as I mentioned. Lehman's a bullet. Jersey trying to get it back. Bester cleared it. This is Dave Reed, 14. Picked it up at center and lost it again. Podupny was checking him. The New Jersey Devils shoot it into the zone. Turgeon coming in looking for it. Reed lifted a stick. Danico couldn't block it then. Podupny turned. Danico through center ice. Domfus steals it from Maley. Backhands it into the corner, and Danico comes back for New Jersey Devils. Pass across in front of Sean Burke. Up comes Brook. That's broken up by Marsh. Two Leafs were there on the move, but Thibodeau didn't see anybody open. I have Brady. Look at that. Boy, he has been making moves this season for the Toronto Maple Leafs. I think he surprises himself sometimes.
Well, that reminds me of a Serge Savard, one of those spinoramas.
I am Brady is the fourth highest scoring defenseman in the league.
If you stripped Ford Taunus of all its awards, erased all the glowing reviews, and introduced it today, it would still be ahead of its time.
Well, here's another look at that great shot by Lehman, his 11th power play goal of the year.
A bullet by Lehman, 1-0 Leafs. Iafredi has 58 points. Coffey, 81. Bork of the Bruins, 66. Al MacInnis of Calgary, 64. And then Big Al Iafredi, 17 goals and 41 assists.
Can you imagine talking about Iafredi in the same breath as mentioning those other defensemen last year in March?
The Leafs have a 3-on-1. Iafredi is in on the play. Olczyk was in front of the net. And what a great move by Dreimer to break it up. Marsh fired it up behind the net. The Jersey Devils trying to get the puck out was McLean. He was stopped. Osborne shot, not much on it. It was deflected anyway. And cleared down to Muller. He comes in with a pass, and the shot is blocked by Bester. Olczyk nearly got away from McLean, and the New Jersey Devils are offside, and here's our first sign of a little heat. The officials are aware of it. They're in quickly.
Many professional money managers offer RSPs, and all of them save taxes, but they don't always maximize long-term growth. Only one manager is Canada's 20-year RSP growth leader, Mackenzie Financial Corporation and the Industrial Group of Funds. So don't settle for second best. Ask your independent investment fund dealer or stockbroker about an Industrial Group of Funds RSP. At Mackenzie, we're looking both ways to manage your money.
Here's a good opportunity by the Leafs, but Driver, the defenseman that had been trapped, got back to intercept the pass across from Iafredi and probably saved a goal.
This is Fedosov, and John Kornick is on for his first shift. I mentioned that. I wonder if that might be a coincidence. There's Kornick. First hard hit of the game. In on the boards. Here's Franciscetti. Franciscetti on Fedosov, and he falls to the ice. Fedosov failed to pick it up. Franciscetti hooked it away into the corner to McIntyre. He was covered. McIntyre again keeping the puck in. Brown chopped it away to center ice. Crowder and Kornick have the gloves off. And they square off just inside the blue line. Now Crowder's a tough one. I don't have to tell you about Kornick. Let's watch.
Crowder, 6'4", 215, was just re-signed on Valentine's Day for this game.
Kornick going to work with the left hand and the crowd. They suspected something might happen. We played 6:36 of the opening period, and the officials stand back and watch these two heavyweights.
Crowder was suspended by the Jersey Devils in September for not reporting to Nashville of the Eastern Hockey League, and was brought back, as they said, on Valentine's Day for events like this.
They break them up. The crowd stands up and listen.
And Kornick's given it to the New Jersey bench. I think Bobby was saying, who's next, boys? Who's next? I think Don Cherry made a real good point in the opening, Bob, when he said, if the Leafs are smart, they'll just talk to Fedosov.
Wait a minute. Curran is grabbed.
Jim Korn
grabbed Curran and dragged him to the ice.
Jim Korn has started more fights with sucker punches in his NHL career than any other player. as Curran was very unaware that this was going to start. But Korn leads the league in backstabbing and has at it again.
Well, that was completely away from where the focus was. It was Kordick in center ice, then going to the penalty box. Crowder had already gone to the penalty box, and inside the blue line where the first fight broke out, Korn grabbed Curran, and they went at it.
And he suckered him. Curran didn't know this fight was going to begin. And I can tell you one thing. Korn should hope he gets thrown out of the game, because if he doesn't, Mr. Curran will be rattling his cage before it's over.
Could be a long night in Toronto. Korn is gone.
Well, anybody that's the absolute instigator.
Hold it. Korn went after a fan down there, Harry, in behind Sean Burke's net. A fan reached over. I shouldn't say Korn went after the fan, but more, a fan might have gone after Curran. At any rate, you got a piece of it there. Korn out. And on the way through that exit to the dressing room of the New Jersey Devils, they nearly had another one.
Well, any fan that gets involved with a player has to belong to the Acorn family. Here's a player, Korn, who's just been in a fight, and some fan reaches over and grabs him.
That fan will watch the rest of the game, I believe, on CBC television.
That's if they've got a television in police station number 6. Now let's see if we can see the start of the first fight. Kordick and Crowder coming right up there.
You notice Fedosov was there and Kordick missed him. Crowder said, okay, I'll fill in.
And Fedosov gets out of the danger zone in a big hurry. Jim Korn did not play last night against the Rangers. He's in the lineup. Troy Crowder was suspended, as I said, till Valentine's Day. He's in the lineup. Dave Mailey is playing his second game, and he's had 11 majors this year, so the Jersey Devils were quite prepared for this kind of a game.
John Kordick told me this morning he was in a great mood. That was this morning.
Most Canadians are hardworking,
are you ready, Steve?
Mild-mannered people,
Andy?
Who enjoy quiet,
Mitch?
Intellectual,
all right, fellas.
Activities.
Let's go!
And the clean, cold taste of a genuine Canadian beer. Molson Canadian. What beer's all about.
John Kordick has left the Maple Leaf bench, and that's Danny Lemelin, one of the trainers, with him.
5 minutes for fighting. Number 14, Jim Korn, 5 minutes for fighting and a game misconduct. Toronto penalty to number 27, John Kordick, 5 minutes for fighting and a 10-minute misconduct.
He'll be back.
Number 28, Brian Curran, 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct. Time 6:36.
Well, you can see that the referee saw Korn's move there as he jumped an unsuspecting Curran. Curran gets 2 minutes for being involved and still breathing, I think. Harry Fraser made the right call on that one. Quite often, the linesman and referee, when they're breaking up a fight, don't see the next one start, but these fellas did, and it's a good thing they did.
Curran, a minor on sportsmanlike conduct. That's Crowder in the penalty box. He and Kordick drew majors for fighting. Kordick, also a misconduct penalty. That's a Jim and a misconduct. Jim Korn, a major penalty for fighting with Curran. And a game misconduct. He's gone for the night.
Well, perhaps the teams have got it out of their system. As I was saying when this whole thing started, I think Don Cherry had a good point. Don't go after Fedosov tonight. Remind them that in the next 2 or 3 years, it could happen. Be ready, Mr. Comrade Fedosov.
Could happen in the next 2 or 3 periods. 1 or 2 periods, anyway.
We know Wendell, among many of his talents, has a long memory.
They played just 6:36 of the opening period. Lehman has scored the only goal so far in the Leafs' lead on that goal. A power play goal, 1-0. John Cunniff was ready, just in case, with Troy Crowder dressed. Jamie Huscroft, number 18, has been called up again, and he's another tough cookie. And it's a dogfight for the Devils to make the playoffs. The Leafs would like to move up and get going before their road trip coming up. Olchek just missed a hit near center ice. Danicol hands it off to the left side. Fired across in front of Bester. Danicol moves up again. Trying to drop it back. Leafs get out. Two of them are racing. In is Lehman and Olchek going for the net. Olchek! High shot! Missed! I afraid he kept coming. And he knocked the net off its magnets.
Well, I afraid he had no choice, as Ken Danico, the defenseman that was trapped, he ran I afraid he into the net. I afraid he was attempting to be the third man on the two-on-one. And Al I afraid he has been dynamite lately for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Here's Lehman. He's going to get it to Olchek. Here comes I afraid he right down the middle. And watch number three, Danico, right here. Run him into the net. And as I said, Al I afraid he fourth in defense and scoring in the last 8 games, 15 points. Absolutely playing the best hockey of his career. And Floyd Smith has to sign this fellow as he becomes a free agent with compensation this June.
1-0, Toronto leading.
If you're a Leaf fan, you wouldn't want to see any other team sign.
Weinrich, number 5. To Shanahan, 11. Up through the middle, Muller trying to squeeze through. I afraid he checked him. Muller hooked it back. And the puck underneath the two players, Muller and I afraid he. And they have to stop the play.
Just because a wagon carries boxes doesn't mean it has to look like one. Time you traded your dog for a cat.
Update action this evening from the Forum. The Hartford Whalers, one of the best road teams in the NHL, against the Canadiens, who squandered a 3-0 lead last night in Buffalo. Mike McPhee scored last night and again this evening. His 13th on the year gives Montreal a 1-0 lead early on.
Thank you, Ron. And of course, Ron will be watching that game closely for us. The Leafs lead here 1-0. And in a minute and 8 seconds from now, Leafs will be on a power play again. Their goal came on a power play. At the blue line, it's Driver. Bester makes the save, looked around, but he looked pretty sharp. Kicking out the right pad to stop it, and then he held it.
56 seconds left in Kern's penalty, and then for 3 minutes, barring any other penalties being called, the Leafs will have a power play to add to their 1-0 lead. John Cunniff, who succeeded Jim Schoenfeld as the coach of the Devils. Schoenfeld was fired on November the 6th, 1989. And that day, Bob, his horoscope read, sometimes you cannot please everyone. Was that an omen or not?
I think it's a horoscope we all should pay attention to. It's a safe one. Brady, no room this time. Weinrich played it on the glass. Shanahan got it to the line. And near center, Dom Fuss flipped it back in. Weinrich going back. Another one called back near center ice. Shanahan and I afraid he bumped. Dom Fuss was in on it. And it was so far behind the play, only the referee saw it and called the play very quickly.
Well, he's got one, I think, on Dom Fuss, and yes, Shanahan's going too, both for slashing.
Curry Fraser maybe just a little nervous. with the billing for this game. Lived up to some kind of billing early.
Slashing. Toronto penalty to number 10, Vincent Dampoose, 2 minutes for slashing. Time 8:02. For New Jersey, Brendan Shanahan
collided
slashing.
In the center for zone, Toronto, and as the Vincent puck went Dampoose into the Jersey slashing zone, they both gave each other a little whack with their sticks. And Kerry Fraser, the veteran referee, has been around long enough to know, get these kind of games under control as soon as you can.
New Jersey with 57 points now. At the moment, they're fourth in the Patrick Division. 56 points, Washington. 54 points, Philadelphia. And in third, 59, Pittsburgh, just 2 points ahead of the New Jersey Devils. Boy, what a run for the money in the Patrick Division.
Make sure you watch that division the last week of the schedule. That's when the playoff contenders will be decided.
Brad Marsh coming back. 30 seconds left in the current penalty. Brady is coming to center ice. Osborne caught up over there and couldn't move on it. Bailey had to drop it back. Now near center ice, Bailey left it. Kirk Muller comes in and winds up for the shot. And Brad Marsh saw the windup, reached out and deflected the shot into the crowd.
The Jersey Devils have a strange mixture on their team. They have 7 American-born players, 7 European, made up of 3 Swedes, 2 Finns, and 2 Russians, who, by the way, don't talk to each other, and 10 Canadians, 2 of whom played U.S. college hockey. An American general manager, and you're looking at John Cunniff, an American coach.
Isn't it funny you say they don't talk to each other? Well, they play together. Fedosov and Kazantonov are out there paired up again.
Well, you know the argument there. One of them thought Tikhanov was doing the right thing in coaching him. That was Kazantonov, and Fedosov didn't think too much of Mr. Tikhanin, and so they sit at opposite sides in the dressing room and evidently never converse. Now, whether they do out in the ice or not remains to be seen.
Kern is ready to step back on, and then the Leafs will have the man advantage for 3 minutes. Here's the play, starting in behind the net. Kern is on the ice. Ramage cleared it ahead to Osborne. It jumped over his stick. Fedosov coming back in his own zone. Kazantonov took the pass. Sundstrom will try to kill a few seconds in the center ice area. Toronto on a power play and can't find the puck. Here's Sundstrom going in alone. Oh, he went too high with the shot. Bestrud started down and Sundstrom started up. And he went too far up over the far corner and the crossbar. Leafs unable to grab it. Down it goes again. The Devils will make changes. 2:15 left on the power play for Toronto. To center Osborne. Backhands it in there. Driver is hurrying back for New Jersey. Hard a hard one, not hard enough. Stopped by Iafredi. He hands it off. Osborne threw it into the corner. Olczyk looks back to Iafredi to Olczyk. No shot for Sean Burke yet on this power play. 1:45 left on it. Lehman in front. Here's the shot. Stop. Pervers came out of nowhere and tipped it toward the short side. Iafredi, another pass to Olczyk. Nobody on that side. And it's out of the line. It could be a break, and it is. Brooke, second breakaway. Brooke, stop by. Jersey Devils still on the power play. The Maple Leafs hand it in there. Thibodeau centered it, scrambled, and Burke made a fine save doing the split. Brown couldn't find it. Lehman dead, centered it. Quick shot by Pearson is blocked. Brooke again across center against Ramage. Brooke waits now. Pass over along the blue line. McLean failed to pick it up. Marois has to turn back with 50 seconds left in the penalty to the New Jersey Devils. Pearson spotting Richardson coming in. Richardson to the corner. He's bumped in on the boards. Fedosov picked it up. Fedosov trying to clear it and roll to the side of the net. McLean, one man back. Coming up. Fedosov catching up on the play. He couldn't make a pass to him. Thanks to Ramage. Richardson to Pearson, too far. Only 20 seconds left in the New Jersey penalty. The Devils killing 3 minutes just about. In 10 seconds, it will be 3 minutes. 1-0 the Leafs. And they've killed this penalty. Ramage from center. Lost it to McLean. Pedepney is out of the penalty box. The Leafs come in. And Pearson shot. Broken stick. Puck just trickled into the net. Richardson has to back up in his own zone against McLean and Muller. Olczyk again with Lehman and Osborne. Olczyk is skating in hard, trying to hit Lehman. Lehman shot! That's blocked in front of the net, and Muller is down the left side. One man back, and Muller coming in. And Lehman got back to intercept the pass intended for Turgeon. Pedepney trying to go in. He is stopped. Osborne got it out to Olczyk. Olczyk made a good move at the blue line. In for Osborne. It's in too far, and he was slammed in on the boards by Weimrich. Marsh. Put it by Turgeon and hopped it over the New Jersey blue line. Weimrich again backing up. Pass comes to center ice from Brook. Long shot by Turgeon. Bester the save. Leafs back. 7:15 remaining in the period. The home team leading 1-0. Iafredi bumped hard as he tried to go in. Albeline threw a hip into him. Maley with the puck coming in. Watched by Marsh. Marsh knocked it away easily. Then cleared it to McIntyre. He got it out over the line to the right side. And Reed is up on the play with Iafredi. Dropped it to Iafredi. Went by him and got out. Maley skating in for New Jersey. Maley is tied up. Now he got loose again and fell. New Jersey bench thought maybe there would be a penalty call. But the play was right up. Ready for Maley. Oh, and it's knocked away. Maley was all alone. Another long shot by Maley. Rebound is cleared down the ice, and Schomburg will have to stop the puck. He fires one away across center to Brown. That's offside. Boy, it has opened up. A lot of good scoring chances.
A lot of places promise reliable brake repairs, but why take chances? Mrs. Purvis knows nobody tops Midas. Steve here has been servicing brakes for years. Midas brake specialists are trained professionals. Heck, I run this place, but Steve knows more about brakes than I ever will. And that's why Midas guarantees Mrs. Purvis's brake pads and shoes for as long as she owns her car. Don't take chances with your brakes. Come to Midas. Nobody tops the Top Guns. Nobody.
While the Leafs were on that long power play, the Devils had two breakaways. This one, Sundstrom taking a nice pass from McLean. He loses the puck right here. And by the time he recovers it, the play he wanted to make isn't there.
Dom Fus nearly had a chance. Marois hot shot. It would have been on the side of the net, but Burke decided he'd better slow the play, so he held it.
Don Burke. And now let's have a look at the second shorthanded breakaway. Bob Brook gets in alone. He doesn't lose the puck, but little Alan Bester just cleanly beats him as Brook decided to slide it instead of trying to go up the stairs, and Bester beat him.
Marois Teflon in there. Has a tone on, got as far as center. He was hounded by Dom Fus. So that's icing as he let the puck go a little bit too quickly. They'll bring it back into the New Jersey zone.
Vincent Dom Fus, who has really had a great season. The last 7 games, he has 10 points. He leads the team in assists with 48. And he's well on the way to a 25 or 30 goal year. And it's been a joy, actually, Bob, to watch him develop from a player who wasn't fast enough to one who's plenty quick enough now.
Big thing I notice about Dom Fus, he handles the puck with more confidence than before. Seems to know exactly what he wants to do every time he carries it inside the blue line. And boy, can he thread passes.
What a great thing to have a winger who can make plays.
Here's another battle. Now, his first shift, I believe, Harry, and Kirk Muller maybe his second.
Richardson's got a hold of McLean. And this is the big line, or has been the big line till lately for the Jersey Devils. Muller, McLean, and Sundstrom. And I'm sure John Cunniff doesn't want to lose any of these three players for fighting majors.
These days, your participating Texaco and Esso branded retailers are worth getting to know. Because with your Sure Winners 2 coupon booklet and their magic pens, you'll receive a $1, $2, or $5 gasoline discount. Or there are instant win prizes, $1,200 in Esso gift certificates, RCA color TVs, cash prizes of $25,000, and 1990 Ford Mustang convertibles. So come in now and let your Texaco and Esso branded retailers make you a Sure Winner today.
The Montreal Canadiens with a fast start at the Forum. Svoboda with the feed to Claude Lemieux, and he rams home his third goal of the year. It's now the Canadiens 2, the Whalers no score midway through the first.
Well, Ron, Carey Fraser has handed out penalties to Muller, Daou, Richardson, and McLean is also in the penalty box.
You can see there that Muller came up with a stick on Daou after the draw, and that's how the trouble began, as they argued from the faceoff dot to the blue line. It looks like Daou is going to get the extra two, and the Leafs will have to kill a New Jersey Devil power play.
On the scoreboard at center ice, Dan Daou. 2 minutes extra.
2 minutes for roughing. Number 15, John McLean. 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct. Toronto penalty to number 24, Dan Daou. 2 minutes for high sticking, 2 minutes for roughing.
There's the extra.
Number two, Luke Richardson, 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct. Time 14:08.
So at 14:08, the New Jersey Devils, for a change, will have the man advantage. The Leafs are leading 1-0 on a power play goal by Lehman.
The Devils are 18th in the National League on the power play, but they're 9th on the road. The Leafs are 11th in the penalty killing department.
Off, grabbed from behind and can't move it across the blue line. It gets in there anyway. Slapped to the line, and I'm afraid he cleared the zone for Toronto. Burt likes to handle the puck a little more now. He's out very quickly.
What happens when you play in that Patrick division? Hextall gives you all lessons in handling the puck.
There's Burt pushing one aside for Fedosov. The Yashislav Fedosov got a pass away to center Turgeon. Didn't get too far. Marsh slapped it away. Burke very careful with that. Made a fake pass that time. And the Devils try to move it in for the first time on this power play. They do, but Marsh gets it out again. Osborne failed to catch up to it. Kazatonov back to Fedosov. Kazatonov to center ice to Dubny Mistin. And it's Reed trying to find a hole. Going in with a shot. Kicking down the right pad. 40 seconds left on this power play. Bester hasn't touched the puck yet. On this extra man situation, it's tipped away by Bester in front of the net. Scramble. Kazatonov trying to take a shot. Bester hangs on.
I don't know whether Bester had any choice but making that save. Walt Podubny was lying off in the crease. Here's the second big superstar from Russia. Here's the chance here now. Kazatonov gets the puck. He'd like to shoot here, but he changes his mind. Now when he decides to shoot, there's no room. As there's one goalie and four other players in the goal crease. And Kazatonov, who has played on two gold medal Olympic teams as well as one silver medal, and for 9 straight years he was an all-star defenseman in the Soviet Hockey League. And we saw him, Bob, and we were in Russia with Calgary, and he was absolutely brilliant in those September games. If he can play that way now in this league, he'll make the all-star team here, but he hasn't shown that yet.
28 seconds left in the Leaf penalty. Gloves and Kern walked away.
I think
the
there was a slashing penalty called initially, and maybe it was on Brian Curran, and then the little outburst began. As I said before, Maley, 11 majors this year already, so he's not adverse to dropping his gloves.
Francis Geddy made a beeline to the penalty box, but he's okay. He remains on. Curran goes.
With Maley, 2 minutes for slashing.
Gillette announces a razor that can sense the individual needs of your face.
Gillette, the best of men.
Introducing the extraordinary Gillette Sensor Shaving System. Sensor blades are mounted on responsive springs to continuously sense and adjust to your face for the best shave a man can get. Closer, smoother, safer. New Gillette Sensor.
Gillette, the best of men.
Now there's Curran 28 and Maley 8 on the inside hash mark. There's the slash and there's the trip. And here's what happened after, and Maley's all set to go. And Curran says, ah, get lost.
All right, they have that sorted out. 26 seconds, by the way, left in the Leaf penalty. So it's New Jersey on the power play, and they have the faceoff inside the Leaf line to the right of Bester. 1-0 is the score. Toronto on Lehman's power play goal. Driver's shot. Bester, nice save, rebound. Bester hustled to the short side, and I do believe he got a piece of that shot by Sundstrom. Here's Francis Geddy coming up near the line against Driver. He's alone on this play. He's happy just to get it inside the New Jersey blue line. Another penalty now. This time, Francis Geddy will go to the penalty box, and he'll be there for a couple of minutes on a call where he upended the New Jersey player inside the line, and he's gone for hooking.
Well, Driver feels the stick on his chest and then goes down with a lot more enthusiasm than he was hooked and draws the penalty. But a smart player knows that if you're fouled from behind, the referee is very quick to make the call. And Driver knew that because I don't think he was jerked off his feet with that force by the hook.
Well, the shots at this point are 8-5 in favor of New Jersey. Lehman has the only goal as you look at Lou Franceschetti in the penalty box here at 16:04. 1-0 Toronto.
Here's a great stop by Bester, and I think he stopped Sundstrom 17 on the rebound as Sundstrom was falling away from the net and Bester was still down, but Alan Bester's been sharp.
And it's Kershaw. He waited too long to try that shot, and Marsh cleared it. Team of Bulls racing in. Didn't get enough. A jump on Driver to go in on the net. He took the shot. Man advantage situation again. New Jersey. Al Boleyn shoots it in. Kershaw on the boards. The Dubney missed it. Al Boleyn takes it near center to Driver. Kershaw over his stick again. Shanahan to the side of the net with it. And the pass comes back and nobody was there. Burt comes out 30 feet or so. He tells Al Boleyn that Osborne was right behind him. 1:15 left in the penalty. Leafs lead by a goal. Iafredi stuffed one near center. Iafredi with McIntyre. Padupney takes the puck for New Jersey. Now he strides up against Marsh. Padupney trying a shot on the short side of Bester. Grabbed it and he held it. 55 seconds left. And the Lou Franceschetti penalty.
Shots are 9-5 for the Devils. The score's 1-0 for the Leafs. And Alan Bester, who didn't have very much to do in the first half of the first period, has been quite a bit busier here in the second half. If you joined us late, those black armbands the Leafs are wearing are in memory of Hap Day, who died this morning. And Hap's coaching philosophy was this: if you master defense, you can win. I wonder if he liked this Leaf team the way they go on the offense 60 straight minutes every night.
Canadians are leading Hartford 2-0. We're keeping you posted. Ron is watching that as Reed goes in and tried a shot. Reed goes after it again. Plays it off the boards and Reed back near center. He falls and he draws a penalty on that play. Bester racing. racing for the bench as McIntyre comes in, and he's draped along the boards by Kasatonov. I'll tell you, there is no love lost between the New Jersey Devils and the Toronto Maple Leafs. They've shown that already tonight several times.
Kasatonov, 215 pounds. McIntyre doesn't ask their weight before he sticks his hand in their face, and Muller gets a hooking penalty, a little bit similar to the one that Franceschetti got, or it should have been actually 15. McLean pulling a guy down from behind. There's two avid Leaf fans. This guy's going to show us a scrapbook. Oh! Got to be standing on your head to read that sign.
Nice piece of work by Dave Reed of the Maple Leafs, though, and hanging on to the puck as long as he did, and finally drawing a penalty.
John McLean, perhaps the New Jersey Devils' best forward, will sit 2 minutes out here and takes away the 30 seconds that were remaining on the power play that his team had.
Lehman, Iafredi, Marsh, and Olchek for the Maple Leafs. Muller is number 9 for New Jersey. Sundstrom, 17. Kasatonov and Fetisov. Iafredi, another fine move to get the puck up to Lehman. Muller now looks over his shoulder. He sees Sundstrom up there with him. Muller brings it in, dropped it, but not quickly enough. And Sundstrom came in and offside is called. Coming up on our first intermission, Don Cherry will be in, of course, with Ron McLean, our coach's corner again in our first intermission.
Gary LaRiviere, Doug Carpenter. 6 seconds. I think they like to score, but I'm not so sure they like the way their team's played and some of the penalties that they've taken.
You're right. Bester has been sharp on three or four occasions. The New Jersey Devils were in very close. Two breakaways.
Wow, the Leafs had the power play. That's what I mean when I say Carpenter and LaRiviere probably aren't as happy as they should be or could be with the way their team played this period or a lot of other periods.
Nanico rifles one off the glass and gets it down to Bester. That's Brown up watching Ramage of the Maple Leafs back of the net. And Ramage starts the play on the Leafs power play. Center ice, mishandled it a bit. Now brings it up near the line, tapped it into Olchek, but offside is called. Pearson on the right wing was in too quickly.
Tom Kervers is one of the reasons why the Leafs power play is a lot better. Last year with the same New Jersey Devil team, Tom set a franchise record for points by a defenseman, 66, surpassing the previous record holder, 62 points, who was Rob Ramage with the Colorado Rockies. Watch Kervers pass the puck. Not many players in the National League pass it any harder than Tom Kervers does.
Brady and Kervers. That's Franceschetti. Backhands it in behind the net. Fetisov coming back. Domfus takes the puck. Domfus looking back to the blue line. Gives it to Iafredi there. Shot. Scott Piper. And it's cleared away. Muller giving chase. But Iafredi, who's pretty quick himself, got back in plenty of time. Franceschetti with Domfus coming in. Shoots it in off the boards, and it comes to Muller, and he cleared it out. Nearly a two-on-one. It was chopped away by Iafredi, and it got over the boards near the New Jersey bench into the crowd at that far side with only 44 seconds left in the period and 18 seconds left on the Leaf power play.
And now Iafredi usually doesn't play the power play point to start as Ramage and Kervers do. Fetisov, who's the target of all kinds of booing tonight, he holds a Master of Sport in Russia, which is similar to being in the Hockey Hall of Fame here in Canada, and he has 7 points on the power play for the Jersey Devils.
Domfus upended. Pegels right on, though, with 35 seconds left in the period. And the penalty to McLean just about over. He's ready to come back on. He's on the ice now. As as Francescetti tucks it back to Ramage. To the other side, McLean near center ice. 15 seconds left of the period. Dana Cole takes a look at the clock, cleaned it up. It's McLean coming in there. McLean's shot going to the far side and missed. 8 seconds to play in a period. Puck cleared to center ice and up the line. Driver takes it. He looks up. That's a shot played on. Bester makes the save. And the horn goes to win. Period. Number one.
Well, the Jersey Devils, once they got Korn and Crowder out of there, settled down and played a lot better hockey. You have to wonder whether the strategy of the Devils coaching staff was to get Kordick and Curran out of the game as quickly as they could. Sacrificing Crowder and Korn, it would be a bad trade-off if you're a Leaf.
The shots on goal were by New Jersey 10 and by Toronto 6. Lehman has the only goal at 3:46 on a Toronto power play, picking it up, an unassisted goal right in front of Burke, and a high, hard one. Coming up next, Don Cherry in the coach's corner. And the score at the end of the first period, Toronto Maple Leafs 1, the New Jersey Devils, no score.
Portion of Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC has been brought to you by Ford of Canada. At Ford, quality is job one.
The New Jersey Devils out shooting the Maple Leafs 10-6 in the opening period, but the only goal on the board so far scored by the Maple Leafs' Gary Lehman on a Toronto power play. It was an unassisted goal. So 1-0 Toronto as they line up for period number two.
Well, the first period was certainly a marathon. Here it's 9:15. An hour and 15 minutes, and we're just beginning period two.
New Jersey coming all the way back to pick it up. Sundstrom put it onto the stick of Brad Marsh of Toronto. Danico rolled a long pass in there on the right side, and Bester is out of the net to give it to Osborne. Out to Olchek, and Lehman is on the move on the right. Here's Olchek to Lehman going in, and he couldn't handle it in front of the net. Check shot. He ripped a high one and missed. I am afraid he couldn't stop it at the blue line. Marsh coming back. Kurt Muller is in there watching him. Marsh got away from Muller. Skates to the line and gets to center. Now backhands it in. Kazatonov is around the net and coming out. Long pass to center ice. McLean has to back up a bit away from Kern. Put it in on the boards, into the corner. Sundstrom got it out front. Thibodeau covered up. Couldn't clear it, though. McLean's shot is knocked down by Bester. He's out of the net 10 feet to clear it away. Curvers coming to center ice. Four Leafs up on this rush. And one of them, Thibodeau, was ahead of Curvers and offside.
Well, the Toronto Maple Leafs are number one in scoring goals in the National Hockey League, and the 20 goal mark is always a bit of a milestone. And you can see they have four that are over 20 and three that are probably going to get 20, and two of them could if they can get a goal tonight. Vincent Domfus is one of those players that needs one good shot to hit the 20 goal mark.
From the faceoff, driver has it to center ice. Kern coming in there, and he thought he had Brooke lined up. Missed him. Pearson brings it back in for Toronto. Reeves skates in back of the net with McIntyre on the move, and a long pass gets out to center ice. Cleared in by Brown. Francescetti is down there now, and he's given a ride along the boards. Couldn't get the puck out to McIntyre, and they have to call the play. We'll be back after this message.
For years now, four-wheel drive Subarus have been helping the U.S. ski team get to their race events early, often before their competition. Yet at the 1989 World Championships, the U.S. team was not the first to arrive. The Norwegians beat them, the French beat them, so did the Italians and Swedes. So how did they do it? That was the year we lent them all a Subaru. Subaru. If you think about it, you'll drive one.
John Kordick on the Leaf bench again. He had a fighting major and a 10-minute misconduct. All that's behind him. 61 minutes in penalties. All by Fraser in the first period. But Devils are in there now. And Mester has been pretty hot, Harry. He has had 13 saves in this hockey game now, and I'll bet you a half a dozen were from that close.
Well, the last two, the two that he just made, were excellent stops. Walt Podubny, number 21, gets a good chance, and then Slide Turgeon jumps on the loose puck and tries to snap it up over Bester, but Bester didn't go down too quickly. And the score remains 1-0.
He was down and got back up quickly to stop Turgeon. Podubny is 21, Turgeon to his right, Shanahan to his left, the line for the New Jersey Devils. Thibodeau winning the draw, though, and hooked it back for Marois. Domfus is the winger on that far side. Richardson chopped it up the center to Thibodeau. Marois catching up. Thibodeau shot. A hard one, and Britt made a save. Lead pass for Turgeon on a play by Domfus. He fell and intercepted a short breakaway pass. Thibodeau rolled it back to Domfus. In on the boards to Ramage at the line. And Burke had to be careful on the short side. It bounces down in front of the net. And the Devils get it out. Turgeon brings it up over the line. He gets in. Bester stopped it cold. Boy, Bester has been hot in this hockey game. That's three times he has seen a New Jersey Devil on a break. That one not so much of a breakaway, but certainly was right in on top of Bester.
Refer to the Child Care Expense Guide. Do I have one? Shut up, one. Do you have one?
I don't have one.
Well, if you move...
The specialized guides Revenue Canada produces to help you fill out your tax return are listed in your general guide. If you didn't receive the ones you need, contact your district tax office.
Here's your child care expense guide.
No, I have one. Do you have one?
You do.
People with answers. Revenue Canada Taxation.
Well, Vincent Domfus, known for his offensive skills, he gives you a little demonstration here of an emergency dive to prevent a breakaway. And here's Turgeon walking between Ramage and Richardson. Lots of time to make the shot, and Bester beats him again. That's the third time tonight that a Jersey Devil player's been in alone on Alan Bester.
Bonner wins the draw from it clean, and Bester blocked that shot. Bester's positioning has been really super tonight, Harry. After that faceoff, he got in position. Here's a tip-in attempt by Olchek that went a little too high. Sundstrom dropped it back. McLean shot through a crowd and hit one of them. Asatonov tried to drive from the blue line. That's blocked. Sundstrom threw it in there. It's centered. Fedosov is covered. Did the right thing and set him up, but Burke was great. Now McLean, he was trying for that short side and didn't miss by very much. Here's Lehman again. Osborne and Olchek with him. Back to Lehman. In for Osborne. That's intercepted in front of the net. Asatonov got it up to center ice. In front of the net. McLean is knocked blind before he could get a decent shot. Bester is out again. Sundstrom trying to play it in front, and Lehman picked it up for Osborne to Olchek. His shot blocked. Olchek again. Leafs want to make changes. That line goes off. Franceschetti watching Fedosov. Maley for New Jersey. He's up over the line. Tied up, and the puck is cleared again. Driver got it back. Here's Driver once more. Away from Curran. As Summerall, the shot off the goal post. That hard shot by Driver, and he got everything on it. Had Bester beaten. but it hit the goalpost. The Devils shoot it down the ice. When Curran touches it, it'll be called icing. And they'll bring it all the way back to the right of Burke.
At your Chrysler Dealers of Ontario, you've told us this is what you want. Dodge Shadow and Plymouth Sundance. Three and four door, just $12,399. Price includes air conditioning and automatic, plus 47 standard features.
I'll take it.
Plus, choose 8.9% factory financing.
I'll take it.
Or choose $750 guaranteed rebate. If the rebate goes up in the 1990 model year, you get the difference. Your Chrysler Dealers of Ontario know you'll say,
okay, we'll take it!
Eddie Olczyk would have been in alone, but you can see the pass was just a little too far, but he does make a great return pass on the two-on-one to Lehman, and watch how quickly Burke comes across the net to make the save on Gary Lehman. A big guy who can move laterally pretty quickly.
Great pass by Olczyk, good shot by Lehman, beautiful save by Burke. Shanahan behind the net for New Jersey. The Devils trailing 1-0. Lehman's goal at 3:46 of the first period on a Leaf power play. The difference so far. Albelin to Shanahan. Podubny lost it. Thibodeau gave it to Dom Fus. He dropped it back to Ramage. To center with the long shot. Burke had to move it. Rebound! Thibodeau was like a bullet getting in there. Thibodeau circle the net, trying to jam it in. Burke stopped it again, and Shanahan is out there with Podubny. In for Podubny, that's broken up. Kershaw carries on, slap one. Another shot, two saves for Bester. And the Leafs get it out of the zone. Tip by Thibodeau, following the play Marois, and he lost it. The Devils move up on it. Off Podubny's shot. Bester, a nice save. Kicking out the left leg. Lehman missed the pass. He could pick it up. Came up from behind, and he had been on the move, going in on the right side. Olczyk got in front, but it was intercepted by Sundstrom. Olczyk's pass, a good one to Osborne. Osborne on with the breaks. Slides one back, and Muller broke it up. Osborne got back into play, but Sundstrom is away. Brad Marsh intercepts that shot, and it's into the crowd.
Well, we fans should thank both coaches here, Conniff and Carpenter, because they both decided to play power against power. Olczyk, Lehman, and Osborne against Sundstrom, McLean, and Muller. And we've seen some great rushes both ways and some great goaltending the last two big saves of this game. Now, Bob, I know you were busy this afternoon, but is that what you were doing?
Fans down that way, I'll guarantee you that.
You have quite a few. I've been down there. But both goalies have made quick stops on great chances in the last 5 minutes. Gary Lehman, 26 years old, Monday. Was that last Monday or next Monday?
I think it's Monday coming up. Long shot wide of the net. Marsh. He pounds one in. The New Jersey Devils will clear it out. They're still trailing 1-0. Looking for the tying goal is Sundstrom. He centered it. Oh, Bester, great save on Driver. Boy, I'll tell you, Bester has been sharp in this hockey game. Long drive is deflected down in front of the net. Sundstrom on it. That shot deflected wide. And again, in front, Sundstrom, and he hit the side of the net. The Devils are doing everything but scoring now. The big reasons they're not scoring is Alan Bester. Mind you, they've had a goal post, and then on the outside of the post, the side of the net, but they've been in very close, and Bester has stoned them. John Conniff was saying today, we're in a slump, a scoring slump, and now Bester.
The time is right.
Coors Light is right here.
the teams who decided to play hockey and get away from the physical foolishness. We've seen chances like that and stops like that at both ends of the rink. And this devil line of Sundstrom, Muller, and McLean versus Lehman and Olchek and Osborne, some great hockey when they're out there against each other.
Kordick is now back on a regular shift and being checked by Dave Mealy now. Kordick hustling in there against Kasatonov, knocked him off the puck. But the Devils get it out. Kasatonov and the pass back to him. His shot wide of the goal. Brown after it, bumped by Curran. Mealy runs into Curran. Curran pushes back at Mealy. And they grab each other.
Kordick's hunting for Fedosov, and he's found him now.
Talking to him. Fedosov is number two, and there's Kordick, 27. And there's Carey Fraser, who happens to be number one in this game.
Well, he's making all the big decisions. He had a tough first period. Both teams were in an ugly mood. Hasn't been quite that way at all here in period number two. Fraser's going to call one here.
We do hope Mario Lemieux will be back, because we'll be there in Montreal next Saturday when the Penguins meet the Montreal Canadiens.
Number 28, Brian Curran.
The full CBC network. 2 weeks down the road, Detroit here in Toronto. Montreal will be in Minnesota. Vancouver and Calgary to meet the defending Stanley Cup champion Flames. Check the local listings in your area. The game, then you'll see.
I can hear those motors from Detroit starting to rev up to attempt to make the playoffs. Four without a loss.
Two games in hand. Trying to catch Minnesota. They just might. With Yzerman just roaring now. Podubny, 21. Daou, 24. The latter winning the draw. The puck to center. Cleared into the zone by Albelin. Ramage back quickly. Marois along the boards. That starts the play for Daou. Marois in behind the play, colliding with Shanahan. They fell to the ice. They separate quickly. Shanahan, number 11, missed it, but it got by Ramage anyway. Fired back in. Three Leafs trapped. Offside.
Well, Rob Ramage, the captain of the Leafs. And what a great job he's done in that department. He leads the team in power play assists with 18. He has 490 career points. And against New Jersey in 20 games, in his career, he's got 18 points. And all those stats are impressive. But his leadership as captain, a stat you can't measure, is the most impressive feature about Rob Ramage this year.
And if you listen to him in our second intermission, you'll see one reason why he is the captain. Rob Ramage, a true leader. So is Kirk Muller, by the way. And he'll be with Ron McLean, Rob Ramage, on our second intermission also. It's coming up a little bit down the road. We have 11:35 left in the period. Period number two, the Leafs won on Lehman's power play goal in the first. New Jersey no score. Osborne cruising in there again. Olchek. Oh, and there he caught the far corner off his skate. Hit Fedosov's skate and nearly got by Schonberg. Puck outside the line, cleared in again. That'll be offside. And they stop the play.
Well, that Olchek was passing the puck across the front of the net. And as you said, Bob, it hit Fedosov and nearly beat Burke. Because, of course, Burke was playing the puck to go across to awaiting Gary Lehman. Fedosov fanned on the shot, and then off his leg, he nearly got a goal for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Eddie Olchek, 8 points in his last six games and 18 points in his career against the Devils. So he's done well against this New Jersey team.
Hit Fedosov just above the boot. Here's a chance for Lehman. Scores! Lehman's second. 2-0. Leafs.
Gary Lehman shows you how valuable a pair of quick hands are. There are very few, and I mean this, very few players in the league today. today that would have the manual dexterity to score this goal. First look where he takes the pass. And then bingo, and this is in slow motion. It looks easy, but he did that without much room and with even less time.
Talented athlete, a great soccer player, and you saw him demonstrate some puck control with a stick that time. Muller's shot deflected wide. 2-0 Toronto. Master is solid as a rock in there. And he smothers this one. 8:56, the time of the Lehman goal. His 41st of the season from Olchek and Marsh. Watch it.
The bad hop off the glass comes right out in front. Lehman, who was playing the puck to go right around, had to change his course, kick it up, and then beat Burke. Great hands, Gary Lehman. A rough break for Burke and the Devils. That puck hit a piece of the supporting structure on the glass and came right out in front. And Gary Lehman closing in on 50 goals. And Sean Burke has been the victim twice on weird goals by Lehman. Once this bounce off the glass, and another time a terrible giveaway right in front of the Jersey net.
21 shots now. Stopped by this young man, Alan Bester. And Ray Scapinello, the linesman, has a little repair job to do in front of Bester, just in front of the crease.
Well, they take that slushy snow that accumulates beside the goalpost and fill the hole in with it, then smooth it over with the puck.
I should say, just in front of the old crease.
I don't think the new crease means anything, Bob. The square footage of crease is probably doubled, and the number of crease violation penalties is way down from when it used to be. I don't know, well, that thing looks good, and maybe the goalies are used to finding themselves because of the curved line now, but they still get knocked over way more now than they did when the crease was the old square size.
Well, the goalies insisted they leave the rectangular shaped crease because they were so used to the angles playing the corners. They've done that to accommodate the goaltenders.
Watch the faceoff play. McLean around behind Muller. Didn't work that time.
Driver moving up. Loved it. McLean picked it up. The play continues, and he knocked it into the lead zone. Coming up to the halfway mark of the second period, the Leafs lead 2-0. Both goals by Lehman. One in the first. Another one moments ago here in the second. Brady got his head up in time to see McLean come in. Lehman got it out to Olchek. He couldn't control it. Driver is back there for New Jersey. To Muller. Muller left it for McLean. He is covered by Olchek. Lehman bumped by Sundstrom, and here's McLean getting the zone. His pass and the shot from the far side by Weinrich missed the net. McLean right for one. He scores! Muller! A beautiful tip in by Kurt Muller. It is back to Bester, but he saw the puck all the way.
Well, I think these lines, the two of them, Muller and Lehman, are going to get all the goals. Muller's play here is knowing to go to the front of the net when the point shot is coming. And you can see that Brad Marsh gets caught not knowing the point shot's coming, and he's not nearly as tough on Muller as he would have been. Now, Marsh has no idea. Marsh is one of the best defensive zone coverage defensemen, and if he'd known that that shot was coming, he'd have been a lot tougher than Kurt Muller.
There's the time, 10:07. Kurt Muller, a beautiful tip-in, and the New Jersey Devils are back in it. Well, that's their 22nd shot in the game. The Leafs have had 13. Stopped by Marois anyway. Dom Foose comes in with Marois. Dom Foose pass, a good one for Curran. Weak shot goal. Danico cleared it by Curran down the ice. Shanahan is in there. Shanahan looking in front of the net. Couldn't make the play. There's going to be a penalty to the Toronto Maple Leafs as Burke had left the net and had gone to the New Jersey bench. Leaf penalty.
Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long.
General Motors trucks, the trucks more people lean on.
There's the hooking penalty right there to Vincent Domfus. Another neutral zone penalty. That's the kind that keep coaches up long after the game is over.
Domfus in the penalty box, and the New Jersey Devils, Muller just getting a goal with the man advantage now, and Muller's on the ice again. He has the puck now, got it back to Albeline, to McLean, and behind the goal, Sundstrom. Again, Albeline shot. Mister the save. Muller was there, but so was Curran. And he cleared it for the Maple Leafs. Toronto 2, New Jersey 1. 8:55 remaining in the second period. And a minute and a half now left in the Domfus penalty, but he crossed their wires coming out of that rush. Muller had to go back with Driver. Driver and Sundstrom and Muller. Sundstrom with the puck to center. To the Leaf line, dropped it back, and Driver rolled it up along the boards near the corner. McLean kept it in. Marsh is going to clear it to center. Curvers went offside. He thought maybe Marsh would shoot it from center ice, but big Brad Marsh kept coming.
Not a bad play. You know, I know they didn't mean to go offside, but it gives Carpenter a chance to change his penalty killers. And look, this is the second period when the Leaf bench is a lot farther away from the net than it is in the first and third. And so now they get a fresh crew to kill the second half of the penalty off. Marsh was going to make a brilliant play. The offside was not on purpose, but it ends up helping the Leafs, I believe.
The New Jersey Devils are 0-for-2 on the power play this evening. Leafs have one power play goal. Lehman scored it and scored another. Iafredi is in. Iafredi, oh, just missed with the shot to the far side and is bid for a shorthanded goal. Iafredi backing up against Shanahan. It's dropped out in front. Kershaw's shot deflected by McIntyre. That hit the glass and got over it. And that stops the play again for a face-off in the Toronto zone. 43 seconds left in the penalty.
I am afraid he was 1 against 5. It gets down to 1 against 2, and he nearly makes it here as he cuts back inside Kasatonov, who turned the wrong way and lets the shot go from the hash mark, but it was wide, as I think Fedosov got his stick and deflected it slightly. So I am afraid he's one of the few players in the National League that when he has every opponent to beat, he still might.
He turns on a dime so often, as he did that time. And nearly scored. 8 minutes left in the period. 40 seconds on the power play for New Jersey. Fedosov, Kasatonov. Fedosov closing in. Bester the save. Kasatonov to Fedosov. They're back home again, passing it around. Fedosov again. Shot.
Two guys that don't talk to each other and don't like each other. Fedosov and Kasatonov, who did that many times in North America playing for the Soviet national team, but they couldn't get the puck past Bester. Here's the best chance right here. And it was a bullet, and it was deflected, and Bester made the save anyway. Ally afraid he deflected it. Maybe the coach doesn't want those two guys to talk to each other. He thinks they play better. I asked the coach about that, John Cunniff, and he said, look, I played on teams where two guys haven't liked each other. It's no big deal. There they are, sitting quietly beside each other, and they just made about 6 passes to each other and nearly scored. Silent communication, I suppose, is what you could call it.
Hand signs from Kasatonov to somebody other than Fedosov, who is to his right. Did the sign language with somebody to his left. 7:40 left in the period. Driver. Pass ahead. 15 seconds left in the Leaf penalty. New Jersey Devils pressing, and they pass it around on the outside. Shot is blocked. Into the corner it goes. Center. McLean is in front of the net. The Leafs clear. The penalty is over. Down Fusa Toronto. A little over 7 minutes left in the second period. Bester out. He's all McLean coming in. Muller bumping with Franceschetti. Puck loose in front of the lead. Then Ravage cleared it. Up to center lead. Or rather, Franceschetti, and he stops. Now it's cleared back inside the Leaf line. And Bester again out of the net. Long pass, but Franceschetti was turning the other way. This will be icing. It's Ken Danico back for New Jersey. Icing call.
I'm going to plunk myself down right here, and I'm all set for the evening. You know what I like about having cable? I don't have to watch what everybody else watches. Want a symphony concert? I can get it. Want to watch one of those witty BBC comedy shows? Okay. Tonight, I'm going with Pavarotti. Right here on my cable. Pavarotti. Bet he likes popcorn.
Cable TV, bringing it all home.
Welcome back to the Gardens in Toronto. This action from the Forum in Montreal. The Hartford Whalers trailing 4-1 in the second period. Shaw with the shot. It's redirected by Pat Verbeek in front. His 31st on the year narrows it. But shortly thereafter, the Canadians get a goal from Brent Gilchrist. His 5th on the year, he beats Peter Sidorkovitz. And with about a minute to play in the second period, the Canadians lead the Hartford Whalers comfortably on home ice.
Not very comfortable here with the Leafs leading by just the one goal. Lehman has scored two for Toronto. Kirk Muller, the goal for New Jersey. Shots are 25-13. Just about 2-1 for New Jersey. But it's 2-1 for the Leafs on the board. Cording is in with a pass in front of the net. Curvers alone but couldn't control the pass. This is Brooke coming to center. Shot in wide of the goal. Brown on the puck, but Kordick intercepts. He's to center. Takes a look around. Slides it in over the line. He and Albeline bumped together, and the puck centered. Brooke was in front of the net, cleared it out. Kordick flattened Huscroft, number 18, inside the line. We'll watch that pairing. Kordick still cruising around in there. He went in and bumped Albeline again, had a word with him. Puck comes to center, and Iafredi decides to come in again. Iafredi going for the net. He pulled down and couldn't get a shot. Brown wanted a penalty call, but the New Jersey Devils are away. Brooke got up over the line. Tied up by Reed and Lehman. Here's Olchek. Dropped the pass along the line, and that sends three Leafs away. Reed and Lehman coming in with Iafredi, and Lehman trying to play it back to Olchek. Olchek going after it again. Marsh steps into the play and knocked it across the New Jersey line. Kazatonov in there for Sundstrom. He has to swing away from Marsh. Another penalty coming up against Toronto. That is soft centered one. Marsh tipped it away, but McLean is on it, drove it at the net. Bester the save, and as Lehman touches it, they call the play, and there's going to be a Leaf penalty.
For a limited time, Nissan's come equipped with something extra, cash. It's the Nissan 25th anniversary celebration. Buy a reliable Sentra and get $1,000 cash back. Or buy a hard-bodied truck and get $1,000 cash back. Or, if you prefer, 8.9% financing. So come in now while we've still got cars and cash.
Now, Iafredi takes a slashing penalty right there on Patrick Sundstrom. And with 4:53 left in the second period, the Leafs winning 2-1, the Devils get a power play.
And they've struck out in three power play opportunities so far tonight. 4:53, as you say, Harry, left in the period, and the shots now exactly 2-1, 26-13 in favor of the New Jersey Devils. But goals have been tough to come by for these Devils of late, and Bester is not helping their cause tonight.
He's the best penalty killer in the Leaf team, Alan Bester.
As the tone off, played it in there, Podupny fanned on it, and the Leafs clear it down the ice. Fedosov took a shot over there from Francis Schetti as Kasatonov comes back for the puck. Up to Turgeon. Turgeon's right wing pass tipped in by Podupny, trying to beat Curran done. Bester comes out of the net. Turgeon was there. Kervers took it from him. And Nandaou clears it the length of the ice. A minute and a half left in the penalty now. I'm afraid he's standing up in the penalty box, watching the New Jersey Devils move it. Turgeon to center. Shanahan with a drop back to Shanahan. He was hit hard on the boards by McIntyre. Fedosov kept it in. Reed has his man tied up. Turgeon and Curran bump. Shanahan is in there trying to knock it loose. 1 minute left of the penalty as they stop the play in the Leafs zone, in on the boards. Nobody can move it.
Well, you know for a fact that Sundstrom, McLean, and Muller are coming back. Dave Reed, who's got 6 goals this year, and 2 of them against this New Jersey Devil team. A silent and unheralded checker who does a good job for the Toronto Maple Leafs, not only at killing penalties, and has shown a little bit of an offensive spurt with 5 points in the last 9 games. He always is a guy that looks like he's going to be more productive than he is.
He's out there now trying to help kill this penalty, and he is there with Dan Daou, Rob Ramage, Brad Marsh, McLean, Kirk Muller, Rick Sundstrom for New Jersey. This is Bruce Driver at the blue line. Passed it into McLean. Season. Tall statement, but watch.
Well, he's made about 4 of these ones. That could have been a bit of a self-defense stop, but nevertheless, he's caught John McLean's shot. It was about a 40-footer, but John had a lot on it. And Bester is playing a game that to his confidence is very apparent. And anytime a goalie looks like he's unbeatable, often he is.
Albeline. And Driver takes a look at the shot. Bester kicked it out, and it's cleared out of the zone by Reed. I am afraid he looks up at the clock. He sees 35 seconds left in his penalty.
Go.
And he also sees that his team is leading 2-1 with 3:20 left in the period. And the New Jersey Devils, 0-4-3 in the power play on this night, come in again. McLean on the boards, picks it up. Sundstrom is knocked flying by Ramage. Pass to the far side, a hot one to handle. Albeline could not handle it. Muller stopped it. Francis Schetti stopped him. The Devils on the puck. Here's Driver, centered one. Muller was there, but it was a hot pass again. It bounced away from him. I am afraid his penalty is over. He is on the ice. 2:45 left of the second period. The Maple Leafs lead 2-1. Sundstrom and Muller. Muller bumped off the puck, but got a pass away. Now, Kirk Muller to center. Hits Sundstrom as he tried to shoot it in. Lehman with Osborne and Olczyk now for the Maple Leafs. Kervers coming to center. Put a pass in there to Lehman, but Osborne was offside on the far wing. Lehman has scored the 2 Maple Leaf goals.
You know, the decision you make here at the pump has a lot to do with how your car performs year-round. What you put into it is what you get out of it. And when you put in Esso Supreme, you get a premium unleaded gasoline designed with high octane and improved cleaning power to deliver peak performance. Esso Supreme, the supremely intelligent gasoline. Esso, going that extra mile.
Tomorrow on Sports Weekend on the CBC Network, the Sky Dome World Tennis Championship. Yvonne Lendl, number one, and number six, Tim Mayotte in the final. If you missed it today, tomorrow night after your local late news, watch Mike Tyson and the new champion, Buster Douglas, on CBC.
It's a good fight.
A surprising outcome.
Big upset, major upset.
I think Tyson will be a little better prepared for the next fight.
Mealy gets in there, and Buster stopped him. Another big save for Buster off Mealy. He walked in alone. Mealy has the puck again. Centered it. Good chance there for the Devils. But the shot by Kazatonov missed the goal. Boy, they've come close. Have just missed the net. Have had a post or two. And have had to contend with the sharp goaltending of Alan Buster. Minute and a half left. Bodies start to fly again. Doug Brown on the receiving end of that hit inside the Maple Leaf blue line.
Well, Tom Curver's through the body check, and he's really not known for that part of his game, but he straightened his old teammate Brown up in a hurry. And there's the chance Mealy had as he stepped in from the wing. Buster outweighed him and made the save. Kazatonov had a great chance, and the pass kind of handcuffed him. David Mealy, who's missed eight games with a knee injury, and last night's game against the Rangers was the first one back, and I'm sure there's a little rust still on his hands. But he's having one of his best, better, if not best years this year. Former Montreal Canadian.
Brady and Marsh get the puck up the center. Danico there, and McLean firing it back in. Ryan Brady, Waller chasing him. He centered it. Here's Driver. Driver's shot. Buster, a good save. Kicking out the left leg that time. Sundstrom centered it. Lehman didn't see the pass. Driver did. Leafs can't get it out. McLean sets it up. Puck goes bouncing high. Now Driver moving up again. Shoots. Buster made the save on the short side. More for Buster. No sweat with that one. He just gloved it and held on. Alan Buster is having a big game for the Maple Leafs.
Well, the New Jersey Devils are out shooting the Leafs 22-7 this period. Bruce Driver just had three great shots from the point, and he can really shoot them. Last year, he only played 27 games because he fractured his leg when he collided with Lou Franceschetti, who then was playing with Washington. He has 200 points, this being his 342nd career game, and he has an excellent point shot. To go into the center ice zone to retrieve a stick, and that allowed Driver to walk into the top of the circle, and you can see Buster bested him on a tough save.
Every man up for New Jersey as they try to tie this hockey game before the period is out. 50 seconds left in the period. The Leafs go up there and look for a cushion. I am Brady along the boards, making those moves again. Here's Franceschetti's shot. Burke covering on the short side. Fencing going in behind the play. We saw two players bump together, and they stopped it, so likely more penalties with 40 seconds remaining in the period.
Well, Franceschetti and Turgeon had collided, and I think cross-checked each other. I don't think that there will be a power play on it. Fraser's done a nice job of taking control of this game. It wasn't an easy one from a referee's viewpoint.
So with only 40 seconds left in the period, those two players would go, I suspect. Yes, there they go. Turgeon to the New Jersey goal, and Franceschetti has left.
For high sticking. Toronto penalty to number 15, Lou Franceschetti, 2 minutes for high sticking. Time 19:20.
The stick's up, and they go off.
Well, the Leafs are winning 2-1, Bob, but if they dare play another period being dominated like they're being dominated this period, these two fellas know that they'll be lucky to get out of here with a point. The Metronomy Leafs are in a down time now compared to the way they played most of 1990. They've only won three in the last 10, and they head out for three in the road the latter part of next week.
Brendan Shanahan was telling me before tonight's game that when I asked him about the scoring or the lack of it by the New Jersey Devils, he felt everybody now, we were getting so many chances, we're all playing a little uptight. Well, I don't think they're playing uptight tonight. They're getting some great chances again, but the Leafs are getting great goaltending. Pester has been very, very sharp. 32 shots over two periods against 14 for Toronto. But it's the Leafs 2 and the New Jersey Devils 1 as they count it down. 10 seconds left in the period. Iafredi back as fast as he could get there. Breezing by Brad Marsh like a bullet. And that 9 seconds left with a faceoff coming up in the New Jersey zone.
There's Marsh telling Iafredi, you got a head start on me. Iafredi, of course, one of the best skaters in the National Hockey League. And Brad Marsh, he takes as many strides as Al. He just doesn't cover as much ground. And they got a big kick out of that race.
Marsh just asked Iafredi, where were you when I got started? And Iafredi pointed to that blue line. And Marsh about the other, not quite that, folks. But Iafredi did turn it on and went in to touch it. Saved a few seconds, maybe, because now the faceoff in the New Jersey zone to the left of Burke. 9 seconds on the clock. The Devils get it out to the line, but it's kept onside.
Conferring with his linesman Scampanella right now, and he was mobbed by the Devils, and he's now saying to Kirk Muller, I have to get a chance to talk this over in my little referee's crease by the penalty box without being interfered with. And now he's might be get on the phone to the goal judge. Nope.
It's up on the board. A third goal has been posted for the Maple Leafs. Of things that's gonna stand because Kirk Muller is still there talking to Carey Fraser.
Well, let's have a look and see why every Devil was so offended by this. A watch in front of the net here. There's only 2 seconds left in the period. Oh, went off the Leaf player's skate. There's no question about that. The rule is, was it directed in on purpose?
You, Daniel Merwell. Assist
and
number
Carey
10,
Fraser.
Richard Van Poos, and number 8, Rob Ramage. Time 19:58.
He's going to let the goal stand. That's a tough call for the referee. You know, if he had our replay, he'd be right every time. They are right about 99% of the time without the replay. But the Devils, I think, Bob, in all fairness, had a legitimate complaint about that goal.
It was really close at the blue line, too. The Leafs barely kept it onside. It was waved off immediately, showing that the play was, in fact, onside. And then from the scramble, the puck off a skate into the net. And after a brief conference between the officials...
15, John McLean, a 10-minute misconduct. Time 19:58.
So he had a little too much to say to suit Carey Fraser. Well, the officials got together, as you said, Harry, and then it was posted, a goal. 3-1, Toronto.
Well, it was a joint decision, but not a very popular one if you were a Devil fan player or on the coaching staff.
And the shots then in the period were 22 by New Jersey and 9 by the Toronto Maple Leafs. Coming up next, Kirk Muller with Ron McLean. And the score at the end of the second period, Toronto 3, New Jersey 1. Bob Cole and Harry Neal in the broadcast booth, and there's the picture for the Toronto Maple Leafs when leading after 40 minutes, and they're doing that now against the New Jersey Devils, 3-1. Now the goal at 1958 by Marois, his 27th of the season from Ramage and Domfus. The New Jersey Devils thought maybe it might be called back in off Marois' skate. It was not. It stands. The Devils outshot the Maple Leafs 22-9 in the second period, 32-15 over two, and it's 3-1 Toronto. Leafs clear the puck out of the zone. Coming back in his own territory, Kazantonov, in a hurry of pass, Brown couldn't clear the zone. Fedosov coming back, Lehman in there, here comes Osborne. He tried to center it. Osborne again. Now Marsh is pinching in. Shot up high on the glass. Olczyk to Lehman. Hopped away from him, but not Osborne. To Lehman. Back to Osborne again. And roll through his skates. Olczyk was on it. Leafs moving very quickly inside that blue line. And on the puck in a hurry. Here's Muller now. Up to center. Kurt Muller's pass. Drop back to him. Muller gets set in the slot. Tested Bester again from 20 feet. Another big save by Bester. Iafredi picking his way in. Here's Lehman for Domfus and his shot. That's blocked by Burke. It's centered. Again, Domfus just misses a great chance. Lehman on the other side. He took a swipe at it. Driver in. Shot is blocked by Kerbers. Penalty coming up. And again, it's against the Toronto Maple Leafs. A Leaf penalty coming up. We'll be back right after this message.
At your Chrysler Dealers of Ontario, you've told us this is what you want. Dodge Shadow and Plymouth Sundance. Three and four door, just $12,399. Price includes air conditioning and automatic, plus 47 standard features.
I'll take it.
Plus, choose 8.9% factory financing.
I'll take it.
Or choose $750 guaranteed rebate. If the rebate goes up in the 1990 model year, you get the difference. Your Chrysler Dealers of Ontario know you'll say.
Okay, we'll take it.
The Leafs get into trouble early here in period three. Vincent Domfus, number 10, after he missed a great chance, hauls down the Jersey player for tripping penalty.
And New Jersey on another power play. They haven't been too fortunate tonight with a man advantage. And they're going again. They're 0 for 4 this evening. And they're down two goals. Boy, they need one badly. Very, very big game for the New Jersey Devils. Here's a chance for Podubny. His shot. Bester again, sharp. Driver up the blue line. Can't handle it this time. Weinrich up to Shanahan. He has a little room and sets it up for Driver. Bester's the rebound score. Shanahan got the rebound after Bester made a great save on Driver. And the Devils score on a power play at last.
It was a nice pass by Shanahan to put Driver in right here. Then Shanahan goes to the net. Curran thinks he has to help Kervers. And that leaves Shanahan all alone in front. And the Jersey Devils, who have had no luck at all around the goal tonight, partial of that is due to the fact that Bester's been so great, got a bit of a break on that one.
Weinrich and Driver assisting on the Shanahan goal, number 19 on the season for Brendan. And that makes it 3-2. 2:13 was the time. Off. McIntyre rolled it up over the line. Danico is back there for New Jersey. Ramage intercepts one. He has to shoot it in. And McIntyre has to hurry to get back onside before the Devils get it out. They do get it out. Brown. Franceschetti was back and Brown saw the pass. Mailey tied up by Franceschetti. Richardson is there for the Maple Leafs. So is Brooke for New Jersey. Richardson got a pass away. And the Leafs just clear it down the ice. Burke decided to play it. Maley comes back. A pass comes out to Brown, and he skates into center. Dropped it. Brooke across the line. Brooke waited too long and bumped off the puck by Richardson. Has a Tonov shot, deflected easily, and it's high over the glass into the crowd and behind Alan Bester. We have a 3-2 game now. Leafs.
I would buy a mansion with a swimming pool.
I would wish for an electric choo-choo train.
I would make my mom and dad clean the whole house, and I would make them go to school for me.
I would play with all my toys.
I'd like to rule the universe and
give to poor people.
I wish for toys, because kids like toys.
I'm going to try to get myself in the Olympics.
I wish I would never run out of wishes.
Quebec will try it again in about 5 minutes from now against Los Angeles and in other games.
St. Louis ahead of Detroit 3-0, and Mr. Hull has his 56th goal of the season. And we've seen all the action as far as goals are concerned at the Forum. 5-2 Montreal late in the third.
3-2 here in the third. They played just 3 minutes and 15 seconds. For Olchek. Fedosov got his glove on it. And Burke stopped it for the big defenseman. There's a job getting rid of the old Osborne, though. He pinned him. Now Olchek shoots it in. Here comes Osborne. Fedosov saw him come in and move the puck in a hurry. Lehman bumped him. Kasatonov got it out to the line to center. Lehman comes back against Muller. Kirk Muller backs up. Fedosov has to hurry back. Olchek going in there. And Fedosov slides into center to Muller. He is stopped. Kasatonov back at his own line. To Muller again. Nearly lost it in down Foose. Sundstrom to Muller. Good play by Muller. He got across the line. Now here's Shanahan. He can't get a shot. He centered it through the crease. Kasatonov played it up behind the net to Shanahan. He's tied up, though. Thibodeau knocked it out across the line. Marouane trying to race in. He's upended. And the crowd roaring on that one. Shanahan missed a chance to move it. Dom Fuss lost it near center ice. And Curran again back there for the Maple Leafs. He left it for Kerbers, who got it up and down Bruce, and he shot it in. Burke out of the net. Takes a look. Thibodeau is coming in. Another penalty coming up. And I think it's going to be against the Toronto Maple Leafs. We'll see. Neither goalie has moved. It's been a scramble.
For over 200 years, Molson has been advancing the art of brewing. New Molson Special Dry. It's brewed longer for a taste that starts big and bold, yet finishes clean and refreshing, with no aftertaste. Molson Special Dry, the evolution of beer.
Well, Vincent Domfus draws another penalty, and we're going to see it right here. Defenseman Danico stands up and jostles Domfus, and boy, that's a very a marginal call. Domfus did retaliate, but if you're going to punch somebody, I guess you should hit him a lot harder than that if you're going to get a penalty.
Shanahan on the last New Jersey power play scored for the Devils to get him close. And now with Domfus in the box, the Devils are ready again. On the power play, hoping to make it two tonight. Driver deep in his own zone. Weinrich left it in behind the net, now goes the other way with it. Starts back out. cuts to center and shoots it in. Faster had to juggle that one. It bounced up into his glove. Leafs get it to the line, but not out. Pendeffi is on the puck before Marsh could move. In back of the net, it hits the side of the goal. Now center, Shana Man is in there. But he couldn't quite get a shot. Weinrich played it up to Pendeffi. Marsh all over him. Weinrich missed it. Reed trying to go in, not down. Boy, this crowd really getting on referee Curry Fraser now. Turgeon's shot will be high on the glass. Marsh took a slap at it. The Devils looking quite organized until now when Kasatonov didn't find it in time. Franceschetti moved up. Hit around the net. Franceschetti does go.
Your participating Texaco and Esso branded retailers are worth getting to know, because with your Sure Winners 2 coupon booklet and their magic pens, you'll receive a $1, $2, or $5 gasoline discount. Or there are instant win prizes, $1,200 in Esso gift certificates, RCA color TVs, cash prizes of $25,000, and 1990 Ford Mustang convertibles. So come in now and let your Texaco and Esso branded retailers make you a Sure Winner today.
You have two power plays early in the third period when you're down one goal, and your power play goal leader is sitting in the penalty box for 10 minutes because he objected too strenuously to that goal by Marwa right at the end of the second period.
He has a little more than a minute to serve in that misconduct. Marwa chops the puck to center ice. Leafs are up on it. Down Foos is coming in. Leafs again to the line. Ramage shot. Burke again. The save. And New Jersey clears the puck. 12 minutes left. 4-2 Toronto. Danicos stop one at his own blue line. And it's Brooke coming in. Brooke with Huskroft. That's broken up. Danico to the other side with it. And it's fired in by Alvaline. Huskroft, number 18, after Richardson, Buckton. Puck was cleared out, though. Again, stopped near center is Maley. Lost it to Domfus. Driver going back. Weinrich takes over in his own zone, and the Devils try to move it up. Turgeon's shot is deflected wide of the goal. Olczyk is on there now with Lehman. Osborne is going to board. Penalty coming up in New Jersey. Brooke is going off. And the Leafs will get the man advantage.
Well, Kerry Fraser got a standing ovation from this partisan crowd when he called that hooking penalty on Bob Brooke. And the Leafs, who are 1-for-4 in the power play, get a chance to put a little more distance between them and the Devils here with 11:07 to go in the third period. Toronto 4, New Jersey 2.
And that power play goal was scored by Gary Lehman, one of two goals he has scored tonight. And there he is at the far side, ready for this faceoff with Olczyk and Osborne. Sundstrom with Kirk Muller, penalty killers for New Jersey. Kazatonov and Fetisov, the two Soviet players on the defense for the New Jersey Devils. Olczyk nearly stole it. Now he falls in front of the net. Kazatonov cleared it. It hit Muller. Muller hangs onto it for a bit, killing a few seconds. Kerbers and Ramage are back there for Toronto. This is Kerbers. Comes to center, one good move. Another good move to Lehman. Weak shot though. Osborne. In back of the net is Gary Lehman. Up front, Olczyk, and it was just tipped away by Burton. The Devils' Muller coming up near center. Takes a shot, a hot one, too. Bester had to be good. He was alert and made the save. Kerbers tries a long one in on the boards. Shanahan shot at it. There's Ramage shot. Lehman! Another smack at it. Was Osborne before he was flattened. Burke made a couple of fine saves. Olczyk is cruising in there again with Lehman. He couldn't pick it up in front of the net. The Devils will send the Leafs back.
Well, the Devils with an uphill battle here tonight. Played last night in New Jersey and lost a tough one to the Rangers 2-1. And their key players have played a ton tonight. You have to wonder whether they have any more energy.
Well, they had a tough ride here to Toronto, arriving at 4:30 this morning due to bad weather and what have you. Maya Brady looking fit, though. His shot, and Burke got a piece of it. There's Pearson centering it. Marlowe fell, trying to reach for that pass. 5 seconds left of the penalty to Brooke. Shanahan. Flip one in behind the net. And the penalty is now over as Ian Brady moves out again. Marlowe took his pass. Put one over to the far side for Domfus. Muller is on him. The pass to Ramage. Shot. Rebound. And it bounces away. Marlowe was knocked down. It's centered. Pearson came close. 8:40 left in the third period. The Leafs lead 4-2. And the crowd appreciating the effort of the Maple Leafs. Applauding that third line that just went on. Here's Kerbers. Right side is McIntyre. Here's Reed. Francis Scotty was in front of the net. But a good play by Fetisov. Out for Turgeon now. Cross center and in with Muller. Muller takes a pass, drops it back perfectly. Sundstrom passed in front. Scramble for, they score! A good effort, and Turgeon was the last one in.
Well, Patrick,
and again, the Devils are back in it.
Patrick Sundstrom did all the work on it, but all great goal scorers know when to go to the net. Turgeon is just that, an excellent goal scorer. But here's all the spade work done by Sundstrom. He misses that shot. Turgeon comes in behind everybody and slaps it in before Bester can get up. Sundstrom's been, I think, New Jersey's best player tonight. He's been on all the power plays, he's killed all the penalties, and he's held the puck more often than any player on his team. But this guy finishes off all kinds of plays.
11:58, the time of the goal. That makes it 4-3, and Carpenter and Gary Lariviere start to sweat maybe just a little bit again. Turgeon's 26th, Muller, and Sundstrom assisted on the goal. Again, the time, 11:58. 4-3 now, Toronto. So, 8 minutes left in the third. Weinrich played it in there. Brook went after it. Marsh trying to cover up now behind the net against Maley. Weinrich stopped it at the blue line. That's Olczyk into the corner in his own zone. Marsh, the defenseman for Lehman, he couldn't stop it. Albelin's shot. And a good play by Osborne to knock his man off the puck. Osborne coming in, putting on the brakes in the corner, left it for Lehman and Olczyk. Lehman stopped by Albelin. Lehman knocked down. Brook took a swipe at it. It's center to Olczyk. High pass, he failed to stop. And the Leafs have to come back, but it's going to be icing as Marsh is back first. That's icing against New Jersey. They'll bring it all the way back. 7:08 left.
My brother is about 10 years older than me. I used to try to do everything just like him. I was a nuisance, always tagging along, but he never complained. We didn't talk a lot about feelings, but we were close. Yeah.
It costs so little to call West Germany, but it means so much.
Cole with Harry Neal, and there Sean Burke and Alan Bester 200 feet apart, and only one goal separating the two. Well, but look at the saves, Harry, 38 and 20.
And a lot of tough ones among those 38 for Bester. If the Leafs manage to squeeze 2 points out of this night, Alan Bester's going to get 5 points, or whatever you get for being Molson's first star, I would say.
Out of position. And they'll do it again. McIntyre went down. He and Shanahan squared off on that draw.
If the Leafs win tonight, it'll be their 21st home victory. That will tie them for the most home wins of any team in the league, although Montreal looks like they're going to win one tonight to make it 22. But that's quite an achievement and quite a change here at Maple Leaf Gardens.
McIntyre won it. Kern wanted to shoot it. Hit center right in front. Came off the boards quickly. Pearson was there. Jan one toward the net. The New Jersey Devils move it out. Driver comes in. Made the move at the line. Offside is called at the Maple Leaf blue line.
Young Scott Pearson has not played a lot tonight, but on almost every one of his few shifts, he's done something that catches your attention. And on that play, he almost got his stick on the puck in a great scoring position that would have put this game on ice. The Leafs have been dodging the bullet all night. If you think the team that gets the most good scoring opportunities usually wins the game, and that is usually true. The Devils have dominated in that department tonight, and Pearson's had a couple. Pearson's filling in for Domfus, who's getting his helmet fixed. And Pearson nearly got the goal that would cinch the game.
There's Franceschetti again moving up, but he took the pass, was not in control of the puck as he crossed the blue line. Had he had control of it, it would have been okay. So they had to call it offside. He was open, way up on the right wing. 6:45 left in the third period. Three games on the road after this one for Doug Carpenter.
Carpenter wants to know why that clock isn't moving a little faster. I think he's thought that since about the 10-minute mark of the second period. But if you're going to finish well up in the standings, Bob, you got to get some points nights your team doesn't play well. And the Leafs could do that this evening.
Driver's pass gets by everybody. Bester watching Turgeon come in. Pearson slapped it on the boards but could not get it out. Curvers is back there from Curran, and the Leafs get it out. Pearson slapped it away. Nearly knocked it through for Franceschetti. Curran couldn't stop Turgeon. His shot, but Curran got back in time to get a stick in front of it. Leafs get the puck out of the zone. High to center. Franceschetti was bumped by Driver. Pearson knocked it down. He was grabbed by Podubny. He couldn't move on it. Now the lead shoot it in there. And they're making changes as the play goes on in the New Jersey zone. The Devils just clear it out. They want to get some changes made. Here's Osborne, Olchek, and Lehman. Oh, a shot! They score! Burke stopped it, did not control it, and it rolled in. It's a big, big insurance goal for the Maple Leafs. Was a hard shot.
But if you're going to win hockey games when a team's had the chances that the Devils have had, you can't let these kind of goals in. No, it just made it. But Burke, who has not been challenged with a lot of tough saves tonight, misses on what should have been a routine stop. And that puts his team in real trouble with only 5:46 to go. It proves, though, Bob, it's never a bad play to shoot the puck at the net.
Burke was just coming over to cover on the angle from Olchek. When Olchek quickly fired the hard shot, then he got his left hand up, as you saw, and didn't quite get it in the webbing. Bounced down, took a couple of hops, and just did get across the line. 5-3 Toronto. Osborne trying to hit Olchek with a pass. Patrick Sundstrom back to the center and fires it in. Ramage back. Olchek saw Lehman moving. He's got two tonight. Here he is. Oh, a save by Burke. Great burst of speed by Lehman. And Olchek just knew he was up there. Here's Muller coming in. Muller got close to getting a shot from close in. Now he's bumped off the puck. That's a Tonov shot. Mester the save. Denisov shot. Missed the goal. Two players down, and it's McLean and Ramage tied together in front of Bester. They stopped the play.
Well, Rob Ramage did a great job on McLean, covering him in front of the net when the puck was shot from the point by Kasatonov, I believe, and it ended up in more than just a coverage job, as McLean objected to it, and he and Ramage fell to the ice in each other's arms, not in a loving fashion. Ramage's job here is to take the man. Do you think he did? We know one thing. McLean wasn't going to tip that shot in or get the rebound. Here's Lehman. He gets a great chance for the hat trick here, but he pays dearly for it as Fedosov rattles him into the glass after Lehman tried to pass the puck out to Mark Osborne. Fedosov's beaten on the play, but as the puck comes back to Lehman, Fedosov wraps him into the tip-top sign.
Penalty to number 8, Rob Ramage. 2 minutes for cross-checking, 2 minutes for roughing. Time 15:01.
Well, the New Jersey Devils will get the power play unit on again as Ramage of two minors. Time
15:01. Well, Ramage was enthusiastic in his defensive zone coverage. And the Leafs are going to pay by having to get a penalty off here with 4:59 to go. Fedosov took Lehman in the boards with quite a bit of force there, and Lehman broke his stick right up near the top of his hand. So he really hit the boards in a hurry. The Leafs penalty killing's been excellent tonight, and they have to do it one more time with almost 5 minutes to go in this 5-3 game here at Maple Leaf Gardens.
McLean of New Jersey is in the penalty box. Ramage went off with him, but for 4 minutes. McLean two. So Thibodeau comes over to serve. One of the minor penalties against Ramage. Man advantage, New Jersey. They're 1-for-6 in the power play tonight. Shanahan, Sundstrom, Kirk Muller, Weinrich, he fell at the blue line, Sundstrom on it, trying to get it back to the line, Driver played it in there, Muller is on the puck for Shanahan, Shanahan on the other side, back to the blue line, Shanahan again back there, Weinrich's shot is blocked, Driver couldn't move in time to keep it in. 15 left in the penalty to the Maple Leafs. Besters stops one for Curvers. Pick the opening easily. And Burke will come out of the net. Number five is Weinrich. To center is Muller, number nine. Here's Bruce Driver, 23. He's coming in. Shanahan on the boards, eluding a hit. Shanahan has to hurry. He has the puck. Lights up. The shot was deflected and missed the goal. Again, it's out over the line. 45 seconds left on this power play. Shanahan doing great work. Here's Muller coming in, going for the short side. Bester gave him no room. Driver's shot hit the side of the net. And Bester comes diving out of the net and says, enough is enough. And he holds it. 30 seconds left in the penalty. We remind you again tomorrow on the CBC Network. Sky Dome World Tennis Championship. Lendl and Mayotte in the final, live from the Sky Dome at 1 o'clock Eastern. And tomorrow, after the local late news in your area, if you've already missed it, don't miss it this time. Tyson and Douglas in that heavyweight boxing championship upset.
Walt Podubny, this is only his 32nd game of the season because of a chronic bad back. The Devils, Walt. The Devils are Walt's fifth team in the last 4 years, and can you believe this? In the last 4 years, he's played for eight different head coaches. No coach would recommend trading for Walt Podubny these days.
3:29 to play, third period. 30 seconds, as we mentioned, on that penalty. The extra 2 minutes to ramming for the Maple Leafs. Devils are running out of time.
Boy, they've had enough chances to win two games tonight. Bester's been marvelous.
42 shots. Look at Daoud do the work on Fedosov now. Reed, another penalty killer, is in there.
Yeah, I get the right point.
The Leafs have had a shorthanded goal tonight. They're working on another with Reed and Daoud in there. But now Fedosov moves it out. He has stopped near center. Fedosov again, the right side. Podubny tried to go in, knocked off the puck. Turgeon, took a shot deflected. Kasatonov behind the net, and the play stopped again. I think maybe the Leaf net off the Magnets with 2:48 left in the third. And the Leafs are back in full strength.
Well, Alan Bester's lobbying for the faceoff to be outside, but it isn't going to be. And the Leafs are getting closer to getting a victory tonight, but they certainly haven't been the dominant team.
Ron has been watching the game at the Forum in Montreal tonight. It is over now, and the Canadians are starting to score some extra goals, defeating the Hartford Whalers tonight 7-3.
Boy, the Montreal Canadiens have found the bomb sites, haven't they, after being a team that almost had to beat you 2 or 3 to 1. 10 goals against Vancouver, 7 tonight, 7 another time earlier in the week. They're not finished challenging first place in the Adams division either.
If they keep scoring like that, with Patrick Waugh playing, as you know, he can't play. Look out. Here with 2:35 left, lead by 2 goals over New Jersey. The Devils have outshot the Leafs 42-25. Drops one back. McLean trying to pass it by Olchek. Look at him. Right through the crease and away he goes. But in behind the play, I think a Maple Leaf penalty. And Brad Marsh has been labeled for holding. He goes off.
In Canada.
Well, the Leafs aren't in a clear yet. Here's a holding penalty. Brad Marsh on number 17, Sundstrom. He's holding his stick to allow Olchek to clear the zone. Fraser caught him, and he'll serve two. And sitting in the penalty box, Ramage and Marsh, two of the premier Leaf penalty-killing defensemen, with 2:24 to go.
Hey, this is not going anywhere yet. McLean and Curran. We're pushing and shoving. The puck had not been dropped in on this faceoff yet. And I think Fraser is going to try to settle somebody else. And Kurt Muller seems to be arguing some sort of point. Maybe it's a penalty to the Devils. We'll see.
Well, I don't know whether this was a planned move or not, but I wouldn't mind if I was a Leaf player not having to put up with John McClain. 9 power play goals, 10 game-winning goals, and 30 on the season. He's a good guy to have 110 feet away from your net for the next 2 minutes.
Well, this is why Muller was upset, no doubt. McClain is going, but so is Curran. And the Devils really now need McClain.
And the Leafs now have 3 defensemen in the penalty box. Ramage, Marsh, and Curran. And they may be 1, 2, 3 on this man's list to kill an important
penalty. 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct. Toronto penalty to number 28, Brian Curran. 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct. Time 17:36.
All right now. Marsh also a penalty before this faceoff. Had a chance to get the play going again. So it's another power play opportunity for New Jersey with time running out. 2:24 left in the third. And the scores, you see, 5-3, Toronto. Muller in, has stick lifted. Puck comes in front of the net, though. Shanahan tried to center it. McIntyre was upended. The play continues. Side of the net again. Sundstrom, Muller is in front. There's the pass. Back up and bumped again by Iafredi. There's Sundstrom once more, and again Iafredi hit him. A backhand shot deflected wide. Now Sundstrom centered it. Bester knocked it away. 1:45 left. Driver's shot kicked away from in front of Bester. Oh! Franceschetti went after his man at the far side and tripped over him and right into the boards. Seems to be okay, though. Look at that. He tried to go in and Kasatonov and couldn't beat him. Kasatonov in. Shooting Bester. Rebound. Hit the goal post. And Bester drops it. What a flurry that was. With 54 seconds left in the lead penalty, and Bester shining again. Little help from the goal post on the first shot. And then he covered up.
Well, the Leafs really gave it a penalty-killing effort, especially Iafredi and Franceschetti, who nearly killed the opposition or themselves looking for the takeout. But the Leafs have danced with Lady Luck tonight, and they were fortunate again as Kasatonov had 3 chances to put the Devils within 1. And Bester, he caught the rebound on the 3rd chance off the post. The Leafs are going to get another penalty. And the 4th defenseman is going into the box, Tom Kerber.
Time 18:42.
There's the first or the second hit on Sundstrom. Patrick Sundstrom's 205 pounds. But I'm afraid he's bigger than that. There's the Leaf Defense Brigade on the wrong side of the rink. They're all in the penalty box. And there's 1:18 left. The Leafs will be down 2 men for 54 seconds. And 1 man for the rest of the game, unless the goal is scored.
Well, of course, the timeout has been called now. Ramage, Curvers, Marsh, and Curran in the penalty box. Richardson and Iafredi are the only 2 defensemen who started the game still able to help at this point. As Harry just said, 54 seconds. A 2-man advantage for New Jersey, provided they don't score. And now Curvers goes.
I wouldn't be surprised, Bob, if Doug Carpenter doesn't go with 2 forwards and 1 defenseman. A lot of teams like to do that, because when you're 2 men down and go with 2 defensemen, that defenseman has to get up to play the top of the triangle as often as the forward does. So it looks like to me it'll be Dow, Iafredi, and I guess he's going to go with Luke Richardson.
Well, we'll see what John Cunniff wants to do. He's running out of time and hope, too. As you see, the last flurry by Kasatonov, the rebound came out. The big guy fell, hit the post, and then it came back out. But Curvers is gone for his effort there. At 1:18 left. Burke edging out of the net down there for New Jersey. He's about 10 feet outside the crease, or the goal line, just outside the crease.
Well, this is a big assignment for these 3 Leafs.
All right. Muller to take the faceoff. To his right is Sundstrom. To his left is Shanahan. Driver and Weinrich are the two defensemen. Faceoff to the right of Bester. 1:18 left. They win the draw in there. Driver takes his time near the blue line. Winds up. He's not going to shoot from there, I don't think. He plays it to the other side now. He gets it again. The side from center to score. Shanahan in the slot. A nice passing play. And don't leave us. 1:05 left, and the Devils are within one. And they still have the man advantage.
Four lovely passes. There's one. In the net. And if that was the diagram that Coach John Conniff was giving his team when he called the timeout, his players worked it to perfection. Al Iafrady got it way too far out, trying to get the takeout away over there on the boards. Now look and see where Iafrady is. You can't go beyond the dot, because this is what happens when you do. You have to contain yourself. I know what he was trying to do. He thought he could get to the puck or the puck carrier first, but then he couldn't get back in where his teammates needed some help. 1:05 left. The Leafs will be shorthanded for the rest of the game unless the Devils score.
Brandon Shanahan, a power play goal. His 20th of the season. Second tonight. Now, we're into the final minute of the third period. And the New Jersey Devils, with a man advantage, have an opportunity to send this one into overtime as Burke leaves the net and gets to the bench. They have an extra skater on. The Devils pour it on now. There's Sundstrom in the corner, big bump. Marsh had a notion to go back, stayed in front of the net. Weinrich centered it. Muller stopped. Muller again. Marsh there, not out. Weinrich the other side. Driver shot. That's blocked. Rebound. Sundstrom shot is spoiled. Marsh a chance to clear. Can't get it out. Turgeon went at it. It goes back in the goal. 20 seconds left. To the other side, Driver now. They're nearly trying to tie it up, and now the play is called as two players collide to the left of Alan Bester, and only 16 seconds remaining. And boy, the Devils are coming close.
Al Iafrady is going to be the fifth Leaf defenseman to go to the penalty box, and Turgeon's probably going with him. Iafrady lost his stick and just tackled Turgeon. So Luke Richardson will be the only defenseman to finish this game. Now watch Iafrady trying to take out 16. He's lost his stick. Iafrady, you see the stick go down? But look at this. And you wonder whether Iafrady might get the extra two, Bob.
I do not believe, I can remember any time. Here's the announcement on the penalty.
2 minutes for roughing. Toronto penalty to number 33, Al Iafrady, 2 minutes for roughing. Time 19:46.
I can remember any time when so many defensemen late in a game were in the penalty box. Now Ramage and Marsh are back out with 58 seconds left in the penalty.